Good evening. Ella Baker, a giant of the civil rights movement, left us with this wisdom. Give people light, and they will find the way. Give people light. Those are words for our time. Just a week ago yesterday was the third anniversary of the events in Charlottesville. Close your eyes. Remember what you saw on television. Remember seeing those neo-Nazis. Remember seeing those Klansmen.
Remember
coming out of fields with lighted torches, veins bulging, spewing the same anti-Semitic bile heard across Europe in the 30s. Remember the violent clash that ensued between those spreading hate and those with the courage to stand against it. Remember what the president said when asked? He said there were, quote, very fine people on both sides. It was a wake-up call for us as a country. And for me, a call to action.
People killing, people dying, children hurt and you hear them crying. Can you practice what you preach? And would you turn the other cheek? Father, 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 help us. Send some guidance from above. These people got me questioning. Where is the love?
What's wrong with the world, mama? People living like they ain't got no mamas. I think the whole world's addicted to the drama. Only attracted to things that'll bring the trauma. Overseas, yeah, we trying to stop terrorism. But we still got terrorists here living. In the USA, the KKK. I can't believe they're still hating blacks today. Cause if you only have love for your own race, then you only leave space to discriminate. And to discriminate only generates hate. And when you hate, then you're bound to get irate. Yeah, madness is what you demonstrate. And that's exactly how hate works and operates. Man, you gotta have love to set it straight. Take control of your mind and meditate. Let your soul gravitate to the love.
People killing, people dying, children hurt and you hear them crying. Can you practice what you preach? And would you turn the other cheek? Father, 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 help us. Send some guidance from above. These people got me questioning. Where is the love?
The question for us is simple. Are we ready? I believe we are. We must be. We can choose a path of becoming angrier, less hopeful, more divided, a path of shadow and suspicion, or we can choose a different path and together take this chance to heal, to reform, to unite, a path of hope and light. This is a life-changing election. This will determine what America is going to look like for a long, long time.
Yes, it is.
Character is on the ballot. Compassion is on the ballot. Decency, science, democracy.
Yeah.
They're all on the ballot. Who we are as a nation, what we stand for, and most importantly, who we want to be, that's all on the ballot. And the choice could not be more clear.
Top of that, add that Biden is running a Hitler ad for a campaign ad. Can I have a little permission here for some cursing? I'm going to give you a little bit of warning that there probably will be some pretty violent cursing coming up pretty quickly. So if you got some kids in the room, send them out. Send them out. Because here's the thing. You know, I don't mind a good hard-fought campaign, and even though it bugs me when there are lies, you know, the lies are part of the political process, and, you know, it vexes you, but it doesn't bother you that much. Joe Biden, in the closing moments of the campaign, before he could maybe become president of the United States, is labeling Trump supporters, because he's labeling Trump this, it really means the supporters too, as Nazis. Have you ever seen anything like this? Now, he might, if you asked him, he might say, no, I'm not talking about the voters who support him. I'm talking about, it's obvious to everyone, this would be Biden speaking, it's obvious to everyone that Trump is basically the next Hitler. So that's not saying something bad about the supporters. It is. You can't separate those. Right now, Biden is calling almost all of you Nazis. And I don't think that's an exaggeration. Now, it's the season of exaggeration, but I don't believe that is an exaggeration. I believe that Biden has actually said that Trump supporters are Nazis in that ad. I don't know any other way to interpret that. And I'm being serious. I'm not just playing politics now. This is sort of personal. This isn't really political. And so I would like, on behalf of all of you potential Trump supporters who are listening to this, to say this. Fuck you, Joe Biden. Fuck you. You fucking bastard. You don't deserve to be president for doing this. I don't care whatever the fuck else you did in your whole goddamn fucking life. I don't care what a good service you did. I don't care that other people say you're nice. For doing this, just this and nothing else, you're fucking dead to me. And I will do anything I can if you become president to destroy you. I will make it my fucking mission to get you out of politics. I'll make it sound like it's not violent, because it's not. I will make it my mission to bring down your whole fucking family. Legally, of course, and in all the ways that are appropriate in political discourse. But this isn't politics, all right? The Nazi ad, you've crossed the fucking line. This is not politics. This is personal. I won't act the same when it's personal as I would if I'm just watching a show, all right? You have crossed the fucking line, you fucking asshole. You were an asshole from the start, Joe Biden, and now you've revealed your complete level of assholery. This is fucking unacceptable. It's unacceptable for a candidate for president. It's unacceptable if God forbid, you made it to the presidency. But this is unacceptable to be a fucking human being. To be a fucking human being. You not only didn't qualify to be the fucking president, you're not qualified to be a fucking human fucking being. You don't run Nazi goddamn fucking commercials about your fellow citizens. That's it. You fucking asshole. Fucking asshole. All right. There's nothing I've seen in politics as bad as this. Nothing. I haven't seen one fucking thing that's as bad as what we just saw with that Hitler commercial. This guy is a menace. He wants to divide the country like nobody's ever divided the country. Look at what Trump's doing this week. He's gaining support from African Americans, I think even Lil Wayne said he was going to support the president. Now you've seen, you know, I wouldn't say Ice Cube is a supporter of the president, nor would I say 50 Cent. But they're certainly Trump-friendly. I mean, even Kanye West is supporting Kanye West for president. But he's at least Trump-friendly, right? Trump-curious. So look at the real world, fucking Joe Biden. Look at the real world. In the real world, all these people that you're trying to bamboozle with your malarkey, they're not buying it. And the fact that you would actually fucking try this at this late stage is the most despicable thing I've ever seen from a fucking human being. So let's dispense with any thought that you're a good person, Joe Biden. You're not a good person. You're a really bad person. Indeed, I don't know anybody who's worse than you. Try to figure out one fucking thing, short of actually killing somebody, And I think that commercial could end up killing people. You and your little fucking douchebag mask, Joe Biden, because you care so much about the fucking population of the United States and our citizens. Yeah, wear your little fucking douchebag mask, which, by the way, masks are good. You should wear your mask. But then run a Nazi fucking commercial. Really? Are you trying to tell us that you care about the public? You don't fucking care about the public. You wouldn't run that commercial. You goddamn piece of shit. I know you don't like it when I use the Lord's name in vain, but it just comes out. I apologize. All right, enough on that.